They were all great, except the, I'm sorry to say it, except the women's fight, and that's not because of Natalia's effort. That was more of Angela's effort.
I was about to throw that guy.
Now, I'm going to fly to the red corner. Enrico Gudan Gorgoshka.
She played the avoidance game.
All right, I'm with you on that 100%, my man.
So, outside of that, I think every fight was exciting. You know, we had a couple debuts where these guys came out ready to fight. They wanted to fight. They wanted to prove themselves. Unfortunately, they didn't win.
No, I've been thoroughly happy with the action, with the matchups, except for that one, the women's fight was a little disappointing, but everything else has been surpassed my expectations.
Now, everybody, what you are about to see is going to be absolutely phenomenal. This guy is extremely fast, technically sound, extremely strong knee. Shattered his sparring partner's forehead so bad they had to operate that day.
Yeah, you told me
that. That's a lost combination. This is Enrique Gacanjia. Yes. What an absolutely brilliant fighter. He is one mean mother. That's for sure. He's going up against Chris McGimby. Chris McGimby. 56 fights, 44 wins, 12 by knockout, 12 losses. He's 180 centimeters, 70 kilograms. He's from the Netherlands. McGimby's a very sound fighter, but yeah. I'm sorry to say it, I don't think he has the strength to defeat Enrique Gacanjia.
For Tokyo and Tom Kerr, everyone here is really familiar with his work, with his body of work, so to speak. And it'll be an uphill battle. It'll be an uphill battle.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to ride to
the
blue corner. Chris
McGimby. He's a good fighter and he's an experienced fighter.
I mean, I think the Surgco fight pretty much proved that anything can happen. But
Gacanjia, he's a power. He has so much power and he's so sound, and so quick. The eye of the tiger. How can you root against the man? Here he comes, Chris McGimby from another league.
I'm sure.
The mouth enters into the ring. This is a 5-round, 3-minute per round fight.
Here we go. That's why they get the big bucks. 5-rounder.
Introducing the fighter in the red corner, 24 years old, 176 centimeters, weight 71 kilograms. His professional record is 36 fights, 31 wins, 17 victories by knockout, and 5 losses. Ladies and gentlemen, the challenger for the title, the representative of Russia, Enrico Gutan. Introducing the fighter in the blue corner, 30 years old, 180 centimeters, weight 70.6 kilograms. His professional record is 56 fights, 44 wins, 12 victories by knockout, and 12 losses. Ladies and gentlemen, the challenger for the title, the representative of Poland, Chris McGimby!
Yeah, here we go. This is
ladies and gentlemen, anthem sounding Holland.
I think the level of talent we're about to see is going to.
So we're
going to
stand out for the Russian
and gentlemen, anthem sounding Russia. Get ready for new emotions. Here we go. Five times.
This should live up to absolutely everything that you would be expecting from a kickboxing match. These are both experienced fighters.
Listen to my comment. W5 rules.
I think it's safe to say there are a lot of anxious viewers out there. I hope you're right.
Good luck.
Yeah, because we don't want to see like one of these like 10-second knockouts.
No. Let's it's the first five rounders, so let's see all five rounds. How about that? A good, hard hitting.
I mean, I'll lose my voice a little bit after that last fight. I was so excited.
That was a good. Yeah, that's definitely a.
All right, guys, round one started. They touch gloves. Chris, the gimme coming out. Quick left jab. Here's the thing, is the Gimby loves it. You watch him, he'll put his head down. And when he puts his head down, he's had it happen numerous times, but that player that expects him to bring that knee up, it's a very dangerous move on his part. It's been discussed numerous times before.
Let's look for that.
And BK moving in close. Definitely on the attack. Chris playing a little defensive role right now.
Definitely feeling each other out this first half minute of this round.
Nothing exciting so far. Quick little like snap jabs. He looks, his punches are very quick. He's very fast player. Watch how fast he throws those punches.
Okay, a little bit more of the aggressor, not too much more, but.
Well, he's throwing punches. Chris is just kind of sitting there. Okay, he did a leg check right there. But,
beautiful.
The Gimby just shook it off. He was like, okay, not such a big deal. He felt it. He understands what it feels like now.
He understands. I'm in a fight.
We got one big punch out of the way. Let's move forward.
There we go.
That wasn't so bad. That's actually happened quite a bit tonight.
Sweep and a slip.
Yeah. It's happened quite a bit on this mat. Christian's giving those little leg checks, you know. Another right high leg kick blocked by Christian Gimby.
Nice, and Gimby comes inside.
Nothing really happening on either side right now. Chris trying to throw that knee. Missed it. It was a nice stomach.
That was a good body shot.
Yeah, very good.
Right to this.
Enrique threw a good body shot.
Right to the diaphragm. Wow.
Fight.
Likes that right foot and right from the side. It's a strong kick he's got.
They're getting blocked. Which one is it? They're getting blocked right now. That's the only good thing. Ooh, he comes in with a right kick by Anika Gakakia. Beautiful. Another one. Here's the 1,000 being blocked.
better.
I'll tell you right now.
Oh. Round, you know what? Sorry, that was an extremely slow round. Them dancing around each other, giving little checks, seeing what they could do. Ended it with an absolute beautiful right kick to the head of Chris McGivney.
Kagokia, you know, waited for his moment and stole that round. That was a round steal. When you sit back for you, you got 30 seconds left. You come out with a nice couple, nice combinations, and that kick to the head. I definitely won it for him. So, watch on this replay.
Flying leg kick, you missed it, and then watch this. Bam, leg down. Wow. Beautiful round the chin.
Right on the chin.
But he shook it off. In all fairness, Chris McGivney shook it off.
And he gave him a little grin.
It's amazing how, like, that flying leg kick would have worked. It would have been a completely different turnout. Chris coming out a little bit more aggressive right now. This Enrique is fast. That's the way he throws it. They're sudden, very fast, and you know, unless you're prepared.
And if you're connects, you're done. As a southpaw, a lefty, I wonder. I don't know McGivney's success against left-handed.
Well, unfortunately, most fighters don't face a lot of southpaws.
No, exactly. Throws off their game. A lot of them avoid it.
I'll tell you, he throws strong, very strong punches. You can feel it. Even his simple punches have a lot of force behind them. He's an extremely strong hitter. And you watch, he's technically sound. Link, jab, jab, jab. Beautiful arm by McGivney on that one. I'm still saying right now that Enrique is taking this round as well. He's setting the momentum.
Yeah, he's looking for his spots. He's not throwing anything. Yeah. He's not wasting any energy. He's very efficient with his punching.
And it really seems that Chris is more of playing a defensive, like, I'm trying to avoid it and I don't want to get knocked out, rather than also being an aggressor, countering as much as Enrique is. You know, Chris throws the punch, Enrique's countering, and he's also being the aggressor. So right now, this fight, in my opinion, the tempo is being set by Enrique, and it's working well.
Yeah, absolutely.
A nice little flying knee to the head by Enrique.
I like how he fights. I like he's a little bit open. He's active. And he holds his ground.
I like his speed. It's got to be a scary thing for any fighter.
Speed kills, baby. Speed kills.
We have a guy that's that fast. Chris is really just dancing around.
Enrique really racking up points with those shots. I mean, it's like a couple of those are sneaking in, and in a five-round fight, and give me some feel this later.
Nice little right to the ribs.
Yeah, there's a nice little knee kind of work out of there. It'll work its way inside.
And the thing is, a lot of his moves are just missing. Nice shot to the head right there by Enrique. A right kick to the top of his forehead.
Yeah, that left ear's got to be a little warm.
Oh, he connected on that one, a right hook to the head. Snuck past his McGivney's glove. 15 seconds in this round. And it looks like this round's gonna end without much excitement.
No, but it's definitely dictated by
Yeah, I agree with you. Enrique totally dominating this fight right now.
2-0 on my part.
Chris is actually lucky this is a 5-round, not a 3-round fight. Because at this stage, I would tell you,
that's just goes to show when you're in a 3-round, you have a small window of any sort of error in 3 rounds. He's down 2 rounds and nothing, but there's still a lot of opportunity. Build it to be adaptable in different rounds. So let's see if he can try something a little different. But what he's doing right now really isn't. It's not affecting Enrique or his game plan whatsoever.
All right, guys, round three underway.
Yeah, I mean, his former had the talent to pick up the activity.
You see that? He's missing on the shot. That's leaping himself over. And I'll tell you right now, Enrique's going to connect on one of these.
But Danny's got to
look devastating.
I agree, but he's got to try something. And when he came out with the first two rounds, doesn't work. So let's open up another page in our manual.
It almost seems like Legibi's hesitant to engage him.
It's not really. Rikoki is really not giving him much to work with. Every time he comes in, he's paying a price with a nice counter or a shot to the body, or that big leg.
Pedro Fitters and Legibi, the couple good shots that Lamel and Legibi hasn't been fully phased by. He's blocking a lot of shots. Enrique, he's just controlling the fight right now, and Legibi's missing most of his shots.
Once you go to the top, he goes to the center of the body, works the legs well, leg check, and comes up high with the foot. Tough to defend.
And Chris is obviously, he's very well known for being more of a boxer than a kicker. So obviously, he needs to get in close. Enrique's keeping his distance from him, which is also good. But although Chris also loves his knee, and he hasn't really had an opportunity to use the skill sets that he loves the most, which is boxing and knee. Because unless you're getting in, and he doesn't have a peak, so unless he's getting in, he has no really chance of competing this match. Enrique's doing a good job of keeping his distance and controlling the punches that are being thrown.
Fighter, smart fight.
We got 47 seconds left in this round. Another round, which I'm putting over to Enrique.
Yeah, that's surprisingly, you give me really ineffective stuff to this point in this match. Goki showing his boxing skills.
He's missing so stick with his kicks. Good. See, there's this flying knee kick that Legibi likes. That one actually landed right there in the rib cage. He has learned the combination. Nothing really landed. Here's the thing. Nothing really landed. Nobody agreed to do the defense. Seriously. No. Let's not do that. Let's be clean. He had a nice, you saw that? He put a knee. He had a nice jab. And he followed up with a flying knee.
A little success about the outfit, and I got a little overzealous. And he's got to go frustrated.
It's a good jab.
No, I won't. Yes, very strong puncher.
I really like how sharp and crisp his punches are.
And first round.
Round four, guys. Two more rounds for girls. So Legibi coming out with some punches. That was a good one. Two jabs, followed with a leg kick into the rib cage. He's been missing that high leg kick on the right side.
Kind of sloppy, I mean. Yeah. Really not sharp. Not on this game, I gotta say.
But then I was expecting Enrique to throw a lot more landing the punches. And he's not really landing the punches. And the punches you are landing, you know, Chris seems so far to be able to be taking them. Ooh, almost had the uppercut. It slid right off the face, but up there right now is a good one. Here comes the knee into the ribs, trying to bring it up high. Good block by Enrique. Both fighters showing a good defense, to be honest.
Yeah, they're both. they both look fresh. They both, I think, again, so far in this coming to this fourth round, it's been all Gogokia's. Gogokia's fight. Nothing fancy. There's
that's not the first time we've seen people slipping in the center.
Nice slipping tonight. Ice capades. For foreign viewers, you know what the ice capades is.
So Enrique getting some criticisms and they're really just hitting the gloves. Chris McGinby. But clearly this can start having an effect. One of these is going to break through the defense. Let's just hope it happens. This round or next round.
Don't be fooled. All of these take a little bit of a toll. And the fact that, you know, McGinby's been able to do really nothing, that's, you know, that's going to take a toll on his psyche as well. Especially going in this last round. Is he going to throw it all caution to win?
That was a good one. Connected on his right, on McGinby's right here. It was a really good throw by Gaijia. And for a second it looked like maybe McGinby might be stuck. You know, when you see those legs do a little wobble, you start to get excited. Very nice combo. Right, left, right, body, left, right.
It's a really great technique. Wasn't happy with those little fly checks of the Gimby.
Give me with the fly and knee. That's why I like four times tried it. It's been an effective move so far, right? But obviously you keep doing it, you know best. There you go. Nice combination right there by Nikimbi. Beautiful jab on the right jab. Nice, nice, right? Kick to the stomach.
If you look at the overall feel of the fight, Gogokia's just having his way.
Yeah. Always keep his control. It's clearly seen. He punches when he wants to punch. Come on, this is a man that crushed his foreign partner with the gear. Right? Crushed his forehead. And quite honestly, it's having very little effect on the Gimby. So right now, it's coming down to points.
It's going to come down to, to be honest with you, the Gimby's really going to have to pull out something special.
Well, it's an option, either knockout or nothing.
Yeah, absolutely.
I give all four rounds to Enrique.
Holding back a little bit, it seems.
This is the final round.
Number five.
Fifth and final round. This is not going to go to extra rounds. If it does, I'd be absolutely shocked. Jim, I'll be honest with you.
Sitting next to a smirking judge.
Judge is shaking his head to an extra round. Gimby has to be the aggressor here. In my opinion, Gimby either goes all or bust. Either knocking out or I'm knocking you out.
That was a man in the corner. Now Gogokia's corner warning him. He's got to be wary of these sort of last minute tactics, stance tactics by Nagimbi. You see his corner getting a little concerned.
Big fight tonight. And this is all Enrique Gogokia tonight. It's all him. It's been him the entire fight. I mean, even in the final round, Chris came out strong in the first couple seconds, but he's going straight back to his old self.
Yeah.
It's either live the fight another day or risk having my head caved in.
Well, that's true. I mean, at this point, the fight's out of reach. Why take the risk of getting yourself really severely hurt?
But the problem is you never really did anything like that, like an opening for the curve.
Yeah, that's insane. Yeah, he really never got out of the way, did he?
You wear your opponent down, you hope maybe something opens up and you can throw your big punches. And this just hasn't happened. Just put his hands down and shook it off again. All night, and
throw it right on the chin. That was a
very thin. Which I'm surprised at. Minute left. Here we go. Last minute. We were down the last minute of this fight. Gimby, he has to know it. They should be telling him it's the last minute. So we might, if we're lucky, we'll see like one of the last one.
Вице-президент профессиональной лиги Китек Татьяна Ступенькова. Дочь Юрия Ступенькова Татьяна Ступенькова. Президент мировой версии W5 Сергей Чепенога. Генеральный директор W5 Дмитрий Иванов. Ladies and gentlemen, and the winner by a unanimous decision, Intercontinental champion of W5 in the weight category, 71 kilogram, is Enrico Gutierrez.